all. Chris Clues here, speaker and author of the book series, What 80s Pop Culture Teaches Us About Today's Workplace, with another nugget of workplace and life wisdom from 80s pop culture. Now, we're going to go back to 1987. Prince was the king of music. Yeah, I know, Michael Jackson, the king of pop. He can have that moniker. Prince was the king of music. Suzanne Vega was an alt singer, and she had a song, Left of Center. And then she came out with a song, My Name is Luca. I live on the second floor. I live upstairs from you. Thankfully, that's all the singing you're going to get from me. You will thank me later. Now, Prince heard it, and he was so moved that he penned this handwritten note to her. Dear Suzanne, Luca's the most compelling piece of music I've heard in a long time. There are no words to tell you all the things I feel when I hear it. I thank God for you, Prince. Pretty awesome, right? And pretty awesome handwriting as well. And he was using numbers for words back in 1987, so I suppose he was a futurist also. Just add that to the list. Now, how do we know this? There's no digital means to get it to her. He had to find a way to get it in her hands. When he passed in 2016, Suzanne Vega put this on her social media to let people know the kind of guy he was behind the scenes. But what does Prince teach us about the workplace and life? The difference between those that lead and those that rule. When rulers get the stage of success, they keep everyone below it. When leaders get the stage of success, they share it. They let people know when they see them doing something great. This is what Prince did. He saw what she was doing and he said, hey, I see you. I see you doing something great. Keep going. He encouraged her. You think that gave her a boost of self-confidence? You bet it did. And you can do this with your teams as well. Sometimes you can't give that raise or promotion, even if you want to, but you can always give encouragement. And encouragement doesn't cost a thing, but it does go a long way towards creating a great workplace culture. Oh, and just back to his handwritten note for a minute. Totally awesome handwriting. The handwritten note is a lost art. Now would be the time to bring it back. If your team is working remote and you see someone doing something great, just drop a handwritten note in the mail. It's a great reminder to those working from home that their team leader or manager cares about them. And as I said before, encouragement doesn't cost a thing, but it does go a long way towards creating a great workplace culture. Don't forget about me for your conferences and events, and stay rad, everybody.